Dear students, good morning to all of you. Myself Dr. Ashish Gupta. I am Associate Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department in GL Bajaj Institute of Technology and Management, Greater Noida. Today I am going to describe you roller contact bearing. It is related to machine design two subjects of paper code RME 603 as per AQT syllabus. It would be better you go through sliding contact bearing before going to watch this lecture. So these are the topics which I follow during this presentation. First is introduction of bearing, broad classification of bearings, advantages and disadvantages of rolling contact bearing, and the terminology which is used to define the or describe the rolling contact bearing, and the classification or of rolling contact bearings. These are the contents which I cover during this presentation, and the next contents or next important topics of the related to this topic will be covered in next coming lectures. So basically, bearing, the term bearing is derived from the verb to wear. So it is like a machine element that allows one part to support another part. So basically we can say bearing is a machine element that having constrained relative motion to provide desired motion, and it also reduces the friction between two moving parts or mating parts. So basically the design of bearings may provide for linear movement of the moving parts, or we can say it also provide the free rotation around the fixed axis. So basically the broad classification of bearings may be provided according to the type of operation and the motion which is allowed, or the directions of the loads applied to the parts. So in major classification, the bearings may be categorized in two major categories. First is sliding contact bearing and the roller contact bearing, which is also termed as a anti-friction bearings. So basically then roller contact bearing, the contact between the bearing surface is rolling, whereas in sliding contact bearing the contact between the bearing surface is sliding. So it has been observed that the in ordinary sliding bearing starts from rest with metal to metal contact and having high coefficient of friction. It is an outstanding advantage of roller contact bearing over a sliding contact bearing that it has low starting friction. So basically in sliding contact bearing it has high friction, however in roller contact bearing it has low starting friction. So due to this low friction in roller contact bearing, these type of bearings are called anti-friction bearings. So there are various advantages of rolling contact bearings over the general bearings, or we can say sliding contact bearings. First is that the starting friction torque and running friction torque is lower as compared to sliding contact bearing, which we have already discussed in last slide. And it is easier in lubrication. We can use any type of lubrication, either grease or any other. It requires lesser space for same shaft diameter, whereas sliding contact bearing require large space. It can able to withstand both type of loads, may be axial or it may be radial or it may be thrust loads. So it is having small shapes, so its mounting is easy, and contact the contact of moving part is point contact, so it is easier in cleaning. So these are the various advantages of roller contact bearing over the sliding contact bearing, and it has also have some kind of so roller contact bearing having some kind of limitations. First is the initial cost of this type of bearing is usually higher because it's having large number of components required for this bearing assembly, and it is noisier in normal operations. It is little noisier in general machining operations. So, and the finite life of this type of bearing is low, so it is not good in fatigue failure conditions, and it is not good for socking. The capacity of this bearing is little low in high socking conditions. So these are the basic disadvantage of this type of bearings. So here you can see sectional view of generalized view of roller contact bearing. So the main components and its terminology of roller contact bearings are inner ring, outer ring, walls, ball separator, face, berth. So these are the basic terms. So basically the inner ring dimensions, the inner ring dimensions are based on shaft diameter, and one groove is provided over the upper surface of inner ring and the inner surface of outer ring. So that wall, when the wall is roll, it is in constraint in direction. It should not be go out from the constraint path. So it is also held by the ball separators. All balls are held by ball separator for maintaining equal distance so that it is not clashed during rolling condition. So these are the basic components or terminology which is used for roller contact bearing. So here is roller contact bearing, classification of roller contact bearing. Here you can see two figures, figure A and figure B, each figure having two diagrams, A and B. So basically the roller contact bearing broadly classified in two categories, ball bearing and roller bearing. And the ball and roller bearing consist of an inner race. Both consist inner race, which is mounted on the shaft, and the outer race, which is carried out by the housing or casing. In between the inner and the outer race, there are balls or rollers. Balls used in ball bearing, and rollers used in roller bearing. So a number of balls or rollers are used, and these are held at proper distance by retainers or separators so that they do not touch each other. The retainer is an thin strips, and it is usually in two parts which assembles after the balls, which is properly spaced to each other. And the basic the ball bearings are generally used for light loads, and the roller bearings are used for heavier loads. In figure B, you can see the radial and the thrust ball bearings. This is another classification. When a ball bearing supports only in radial direction on radial load, and the radial load, it depends on the plane of rotation of the ball, which is normal to the center line of the bearings, which you can see in figure. And the action of thrust load, the action of thrust load is to shift the plane of rotation of the balls, which you can see in figure of thrust bearing. So basically the radial and the thrust loads carried both loads carried simultaneously on bearing.